So the specific research that I'm doing, I'm going to be working on the soil composition to find out what will grow best here. And we also wanted to find out what's growing now was the goal. So we came out and we did a survey of the area and we counted plants to see what's growing now and how we can help other things that are native grow here too. We're working with the Boise River Enhancement Network and the city of Boise to help rehabilitate a 12-acre hillside of the Hyatt Hidden Wetlands Reserve here in Boise. It's a hillside that's just completely overgrown with invasive species, and we'd like to see it have more native bunch grasses and annual forbs.
We're really trying to show the value of wetlands, especially in urban settings like here in Boise. So what part of my research is to collect air particulate samples throughout this 44-acre site and then compare them to other sites down the road. And I want to use those particulates, see what the pollutants are, and kind of show that they are improving air quality and we should really care about wetlands and care about improving our environment by wetlands.
What we're working on is measuring air quality levels around Boise and comparing them to a stationary monitor that's located in Meridian. And what we're kind of doing is we're looking at how air quality varies over a wide spatial area as compared to just a single stationary monitor. So Greenbelt, obviously the levels are much better than you'll see downtown. Downtown it tends to spike around rush hour, major intersections like Front and Capitol Street. Over here the air quality is a lot better, I would say.
The intent of the research is to kind of see how the particulate matter and the air quality changes basically over a really short distance. We're finding that there's, depending on the time of day and what block you're on, there can be huge disparities, sometimes hundreds of times greater particulate matter 2.5 in the air from block to block, which is a really interesting so far. That's a lot different from what I expected. The thing that I really want to find out is just how big of a difference there is between traveling on the Greenbelt, like coming in downtown, because that way sensitive populations, it's nice to know if somebody wants to bike to work, what is the best, healthiest way for them to be getting to work, getting around where they need to go. We don't have enough information to say anything definitively yet, but once a year has rolled around, we could make some assumptions about how things change seasonally.